First and 10. Here's Kaepernick. He'll run it. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
He's crossing. He's checking cross. Check nickel. Check run.
Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. And this is incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
Kaepernick again here on second and 10, eluding the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. We'll find Gibson here complete. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Now, Kaepernick again. This will be caught at about the 5.
Kaepernick.
And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
And goal at the Steelers' 4-yard line.
Again, it's Kaepernick. This is caught. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Antonio Gibson. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And Washington has taken a first quarter lead.
Well, this may be an adventure this afternoon, but this one is good.
Steelers nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Brings up second and a yard.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Washington defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Mark 30 yards.
Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. The end result, 21 yards.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice game.
Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Chicken down right at the line.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Second and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Throwing on second down, Roethlisberger. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
At the 7-yard line.
Tossing this out wide to McFarland. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On second and goal, Roethlisberger. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Eric Ebron with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. At 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Logan Thomas.
10 yards there. Good for a Washington first down.
First down. Washington.
Working from the gun. It's Kaepernick. Escaping the pressure right. This is caught. And a big gain that time. He's out of bounds on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 7-7, our score after one.
With the score tied 7-7.
So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
Short of the goal line. A gain of 3.
On second down, it's Gibson. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal?
No gain on the play.
Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside.
TSG housing. I feel like I know who that is. I think that's the what's that? The Ravens? I think it's the Ravens.
Break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on fourth and goal. And they'll run for it with Miller. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Lamar Miller. His third touchdown now on the year. And Washington has taken the lead.
His kick. Oh, this is what I love about calling these games. Fourth and goal. This is all about leverage. Who wants it more? And who's going to get it done at the point of attack, the line of scrimmage.
Fielded in the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Let's see what he does to this. Every time I come out in that form, he thinks I'm trying to run the ball. I might run it this time, for real.
The Pittsburgh offense center at the line to start their next drive. But that last drive,
I like this
so
stuff.
Effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown.
Bro.
Down he goes.
Well, for last user rush ass so good, he was named NFC defensive. My running back did block him.
A lot of praise, and understandably so, from national media. Looking pretty good on that play, too.
And I love what he told us this week before the game. He talked about how much time they spend working on pass rush moves every position, because anyone could go after the quarterback in their defense, and you can see how they've all absorbed their lessons.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Another try after the first down sack.
Roethlisberger. Hammer. Don't give me that.
Catch number 44 of all the year. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
Now Roethlisberger to throw.
Oh, I meant to throw that out of bounds. Oh, shit. I thought he was going to run out of bounds. Damn.
Washington touchdown.
I thought he was going to run out of bounds.
Now remember, this is the number one defense.
I really thought I could just throw the ball away to Ebron.
There's a good example of why.
Oops.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way. All
right, now I'm about to go score. Oh, I didn't mean to catch that. Damn.
And this will not be returned.
Too sticky.
It'll come out to the 25.
Their own 25-yard line.
Ravens must be watching on his phone, because I don't even see his review up there.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
Does he have no outsiders on?
Pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
Why isn't my boy in? I have, yeah, McFarland starting, bro. Why the fuck was he not in that play? That might have been good yardage. OT Hammer, I know what you don't like. You don't like run, and you can't come on power like that, son.
After the pickup of five, here, second and five.
Let's see what we got right here.
Now it's Roethlisberger. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit.
Oh, T. Hammer. Don't run cover two on that. T. Hammer. Oh, God. When you get cover two, I'm going to get to waxing that. You do that. I'm going to get to waxing that, T. Hammer. Oh, Lord. We finna run the ball on him now. Don't let me find out that T. Hammer can't stop the fucking run.
Running with McFarland.
Callie, go to your bed. Go to your bed. She's in a mood. Sit down.
Here's Roethlisberger to throw.
Good catch, boy. We got, bro, T. Hammer, stop trying to user rush me, bro. Come on now. Like, stop it. Come on now. We on that. We on that. We on that. We on that, T. Hammer. What's good? What's good? Come on now. Yeah. Backside. Backside. Get sticky with him. Get sticky with him, nigga. Yeah. Definitely can hear you. They heard you from the moment you came in. Mm-hmm. It's only two people watching right now, but usually I get about 20 views because I got two leagues that I'm in, so I get about 20 views on my YouTube shit. Don't run! Don't! He's not conservative anyways, but we still hitting his ass. Alright. So now what we finna do is... No, just don't play it like OD. Yeah, just not finna OD. We finna play over the top every play. His ass is fried. Out there, set ready for this next fried. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half. I didn't get my fucking... He's going to hit the cover three beater. I didn't get him. I didn't get the fucking deep half my guys because I had to switch formations. And that shit took forever. Now I gotta go march again to go put him at 7 points. Golly. I'm sick because I already knew he was just gonna run, but he runs the same shit. He actually should be a rule for this nigga T. Hammer. I'm not gonna lie. As much as I watch him run the same shit, like every time he comes on this game. That's why I have no shame in me just going to... I'm going to run the same plays on him. Because until he stops him, like, I truly think he's not going to be able to stop power and stretch. Which is tragic. Like, it's very tragic. He can't stop stretch and power. And I come from a league where if you can't stop stretch and power, you can't fucking play. Like, oh, you can play, but it's not going to be this. He's gonna think that I'm running again. Yep. That was supposed to be to the other side. He clicked off. He's so weak. Oh my god. He probably doesn't think I'm running here. I am literally running this football. It's like, nah, I'm about to pass.
Speaking of winning, to be as cheesy as we can, he was the winner of the NFC Defensive Player of the Week award from last week, so he's really stringing together some good football. So not only did he get a gold star,
and it's intercepted. That's what I get for not throwing it to X. I really thought he was going to run with it.
Jonathan Coachman of the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games.
Go to flat route, T-Hammer.
Around the NFL.
Go to flat route. He shouldn't have been able to catch that. Oh my god.
And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead. Flushed out right.
Out of bounds. Thank you.
Out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
He's the type of nigga that you really have to like double maple both sides. Like,
and it results in an incomplete pass.
That's so weak.
He's gonna drop this one down to Gibson.
I can do that, like
just outside of the 10 at the 11. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Third down.
On a slant complete.
That's supposed to be a pick. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. That he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Antonio Gibson, he scored on the ground and through the air.
It should be really a rule against spam. Like, bro, I literally can't make no adjustments.
Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. They should lead down to 3 touchdowns at 21.
I literally can't make no adjustments.
Like, the way that, like, everybody knows, when you reload, when you spam,
kick this one away and
Madden is lagging. By the time I get back to actually go to the huddle, bro, you like by the time I get to actually make an adjustment, you can already snap the ball. And like if you want to do that, okay. Come on now, like play a decent game of Madden. That's not decent. That's actually half-ass as fuck.
Do you think they'll play this?
So I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, whip your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But it's also something to challenge in your offense right here. You know, hey guys, you help.
Yeah, I might not even play him just for that shit. That shit is so weak.
Let's go make some plays.
And he connects with Ebron. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third.
Because it's not even worth doing the same shit back, because that shit is not genuinely fun. Like, if you're just going to sit there and run the same stuff and we're just going to spam it back and forth until, like, it's just a, oh, get to your player and load up fast enough.
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Second and 9, Roethlisberger. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And he'll go out of bounds, making it all the way down to the 5.
First and goal at the 5.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Play of the half. It's Roethlisberger. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach, and how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick.
It definitely said he picked, too. It said he picked kickoff.
Socked much of the East Coast, not going away as we are back to it in the second.
That's the only reason why I chose onside. It said he picked kickoff. Wow. That's weird.
Losing Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week.
That shit is so lame, bro. Come on, throw the same shit. Throw the same shit. Bro, yeah, that shit is so lame, bro. That shit is so weak. Come on now, bro. Like,
looking at it from the defense's perspective, they could have really
weak ass coverage
into this deficit.
Yeah, because now possessions so crucial.
What's up?
At this stage of the game, and when you've got an opportunity to hop on a turnover and you don't get it, you can feel the frustration all the way up here.
And the offense, they're living right now. Another bounce and break.
I'm gonna try to run
way.
Some other bullshit. Come on, what's up, right. T Hammer?
Open man here is Foster.
Oh my god, that's supposed to be a pick.
Inside the 30. A gain there of 21 yards.
Now I got a quarterback contained.
First and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's what really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And incomplete as he was knocked.
Whole time, if I really took this serious, I actually think I really could have beat him on some back real shit.
And the timing of a guy trying to throw the football.
Time,
and on pass play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Kaepernick will try again on second down. Escaping the pressure right.
Yeah, give me that shit. That weak ass shit. That weak ass shit. That shit weak. Please run cover two right here.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at the 20. After the interception, here's Roethlisberger.
Oh my gosh, bro. Like, that doesn't even take skill. This coverage is fucking shitty. He's running shitty coverage. Oh my goodness gracious. That doesn't take skill to get a fucking block. I mean, a block shed. Yeah, bro, this, I ain't gonna lie, this is the most e-champ shit. I still threw a bullshit ass route. That shit just so champ. Like, how do you feel to run the same maple every play? Like, I understand you're a YouTuber, but like, bro, I don't even think it takes remote skill. To run the same maple every play. Like, understand where I'm coming from. That should have been a pick.
Can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Come on, go ahead and flip it.
Position to begin the drive, and now they look up at a third and five. Into a double team.
That weak ass shit.
Picked off by the all-pro safety, Micah Fitzpatrick.
Weak ass shit.
And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line. I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after...
This nigga T-Hammer is so weak, actually. If I was given another opportunity, this nigga would actually lose, I think, on some real funny shit. Dot. On your sideline. Come on, nah, let's run this again. Let's run this again. I like that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, how you like that? How you like that? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 let's run that. Yeah, hurry up now, bitch. Let's go. Fuck ass, nigga. That shit's so weak. Come on. This is just how I talk, by the way. Ravens, I just be bullshitting them, niggas. I could care less about this game. I'm tanking anyways, like I said. I do watch my boy T-Hammer, though, so this shit is weak. That shit is weak. That shit is weak. He should have fumbled. Cough up my football. Come on, you gonna flip it? What's up? You gonna flip it? I'm ready for you to flip it. Oh, yeah, I'm ready for that. Wait, you got on curl flats? Oh, we got on hard flats over there. Oh, that's not it. I know how to stop that. That's a bet. Come on, do that again. Because that's the only other thing you have on the field, honestly.
I'll tell you, far from yep. ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down. Now a play fake. Kaepernick.
A delay fade, cute. That's not gonna hold up too long. Keep on conservative taking those hits.
The catch and run there, good for 16 in the first. into the red zone now. Kaepernick.
Yep, box. Box that. Put it in a wrapper for me. Oh my God. That's right, Minka. Good tackle, boy. Cause what, bro? D hop? Come on, bro. I left the hard flat there on purpose. I ran commit middle. No, sir. Even in big nickel, I ran commit middle. Run it again if you want. Yeah. Run. I'm right this time. To the right this time. I should have double middle. That's just a good guess.
Taken about 7 yards deep, and he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency.
Come on now, stop playing with me, bro. Come on, we could do this all day long.
Way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Now Roethlisberger, and his pass is
I double tapped X. That hurts.
Picked off by Troy Apke.
I double tapped X. Ouch.
And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. Back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season,
ouch.
It's been a big year.
Good old double tap.
Back-to-back weeks, tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this.
Good old double tap. I'm literally going to come out in the same thing. Because for fact, he actually couldn't stop it. This dude thinks he's like the slickest guy, cause like you just rush with Ashton Davis. All I have to do is just mic him. Yeah, bro. Like I know how to stop that. I just don't choose to because who rushes every day? Hey, give me that, Ebron. Give me that, Ebron. All confidence with that throw. If you know, you know. Stop playing that cover two, boy. We're going to hurry it up now because that's what T. Hammer was doing to me. Yeah, we're just going to hurry it up. Move. Throw your bed. Ha. Get my block. I hit my fullback too, boy. Oh, and then you're going to click off. I don't have no respect for this scary ass boy. Scary ass boy, bro. I just threw that up. Good tank. Yes, sir.
Experience or less talent, but a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ball game, I would have said never, not in a million years, but here we go.
Stop playing with me, bro. That's not there. Like, out of all the things that's been there, that hasn't been one of them. Honest to God, truth.
Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they love
Wow. I can't even say that Devin Bush didn't, like, just get slayed right there. Nope. Oh, no. Oh, no. He do that. You had to have known that was a bad. Come on now. Not even D-Hop or Scary Terry, just Robert Foster. And that should have been a flat route pick. I'm not even going to hold you. Jesus. I'm really just fucking off, man. I hate this Steelers team so much, bro. I hate this team without, like, reason.
Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys...
How did he not...
...on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
You're so weak with the click-off, bro. I gotta tell him... he's scary with the click off, bro. Let me find out. T-Hammer really can't fucking tackle. Like, that's the only reason people don't tackle, right? You click off. I mean, you click off because you don't tackle, right? That shit weak, T. Come on, see him, but don't click off on me now. That shit's so weak. Stop that. Oh, I did not mean to press hurry up. Heathen! What a heathen! What a heathen! A Shadugan! And a Shadugan! Oh, fuck. We whiffed the kick. The Shadugan? You should have threw the... You see the ball? Dot. That's a dot on T-Hammer head. I'm really just messing with him too, for real. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
It's been a back and forth game, a lot of points on the board, and that return right there kind of indicative of how
they're going. Hey, let me stop before. Hey, bro, let me stop. Let me stop before. Let me stop before they think that I'm. Yeah, let me stop. Alright. Now that we got out that the system. I need to mute my mic, or is it bullshit? Not like bullshit, but like. Hold up.
Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory. But it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one.
Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Roethlisberger looking deep here for Ebron. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, is intended target. And it's second down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
First and 10 at the 33-yard line.
To throw again is Roethlisberger. He'll let this go for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
Bro, y'all see that fucking lag? That shit was so weak. Because I don't do that.
He like, I don't even know what to say.
I have no... Hey, I ain't gonna lie, this nigga T Hammer's connection is shit, bro. I've been lagging like all game. Throw it. Ah! You the rush, ho!
Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. Here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. He will go out right near the 35-yard line.
A real quick snap and hoe, if y'all ain't never met one.
On those last two plays. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. 15. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He's got it.
That's a bad ball. That's actually a terrible ball. Like, out of all the reads he had on the field, that's a terrible ball.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. And they'll take a knee as the clock ticks down toward 50 seconds to go. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. From back at the four, here's second and goal. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. Now hold on a second, why would they decline that?
I don't have a good answer for you, but let's work the math here a little bit.
I don't want a knee, yeah. I was about to say.
You're in the positive in the yardage, and you get to rerun the down.
Oh, my God. Oh, we should have had a pick. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord, fellas. That's what I wanted. I wanted a pick out his ass, man. Don't let them Colin Kaepernick stats go on. Cali, move, please. Like, all the way, move. All the way, move. Go to your bed. He's gonna be like, why does this kid keep trying to like do shit against me? Oh, chill, my bro. Ebron be so open. I'd be so mad about that. Like,
now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game.
I can hear him screaming now. Use a rush. Oh, please block. Yeah, please do this.
They're going on fourth down. It's Roethlisberger.
Yeah, you see that dot, T Hammer? Stop playing with me, bro. Cali.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Washington, the streak continues as they push their mark to a perfect 12-0 now on the year. And they'll get another road test next week as they have to go to Santa Clara to take on the 49ers. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, it's another week with more questions than answers as they fall to 3-9. And they'll try to get back on track next week.
Nah, this is that white boy I be playing. I mean, that I be watching. The one that should be making fun of his haircut. Yeah, I told you I was in a league with that nigga. He's gonna see this, but he's not gonna care. I make fun of his hair too. But y'all see the dots though. Nobody can. I like that nobody can really run the ball on me. I held the Ravens guy too. Ebron Nation.